Very good evening, my brothers and sisters. Greetings in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We continue, beloved, our study about the church. Let us go to the book of Philippians, chapter 4 and verse 7. Philippians 4, 7 reads as follows, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this another opportunity that you have granted unto us. Lord, we pray that you will continue to bless us, continue to use us, Lord, to your honor and to your glory. Help us, dear God, that as we study thy word together, we will keep it in our hearts, that we will not sin against thee. We ask it in the blessed name of Jesus. Amen. This is your friend and pastor, Carlo Lord. We are coming to you from the First Baptist Church of Paraiso, Panama, the Republic of Panama. Tonight we want to talk about the church, a prayerful people. The church, a prayerful people. Philippians 4 and verse 7, that was just read. Beloved, we talk a lot about prayer, yet it is practiced by a small amount of followers of Jesus. We find ourselves praying mostly when we are in need or in some problem. Jesus told a parable to show men that they should always pray. We find this in Luke chapter 18. Now, as the church of God, we ought to pray with persistence, with passion, with thankfulness, and even making intercession for others. Let's take these one by one. Praying with persistence. Colossians 4 and verse 2 tells us, "Devote yourselves to prayer." Devote yourself to prayer. We shall never grow tired of praying for something or for someone. Paul uses the word devote. Our persistence is an expression of our faith that God will answer our prayers. Now listen, God might be slow in answering, but he is sure. Therefore, our faith should not die. Watch this. God's delay, as we might call it, could be God's way of working his will in our lives. Don't you think so? God's delay, beloved, could be his way of working a miracle in our lives. Listen, if you should grow tired of praying, just keep in mind that God is present and listening and will someday answer your prayer. The problem is never with God. The problem is always on our part. We forget that God's way is not our way. And so God may answer in a way that we did not expect. But remember this, God's ways are always best. Remember, it was Jesus that told us to ask, to seek, and to knock. He said, "If we ask, it shall be given. If we seek, we shall find. And if we knock, the doors will be opened." So, brothers and sisters, let us keep on asking. Let us keep on seeking. And let us keep on knocking till he answers our prayers. Number two, how about praying with passion? Jesus is our perfect example of praying with passion. Remember, at his baptism, while he was praying, the heavens was open. Listen now, passionate prayer will open heaven's gate. Before calling his disciples, he spent the whole night in prayer. Passionate prayer will give us the right direction Read Luke chapter 6, beloved. Then we should pray with thankfulness. Paul tells us right here in Philippians 4 and verse 6 that when we pray, to give thanks in everything. Now that's not easy, okay? But listen on. We should give thanks at all times. In Colossians 3, tell us that in everything we say or do should be done in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to Him. We should thank God in every circumstances, beloved. Then we should pray making intercession. This simple means that praying for others. When we go to God in prayer, we should remember others. Just as we pray for God's will to be done in our lives, we should also pray for the will of God to be done also in the life of others. When we pray for others, when we pray for the work of God to be done and for His wish to be accomplished, He will begin to use us, hence making room for us to grow in ways that others around us will be what? Astonished. Now, let me ask, could it be that at times we have not become all that God wants us to become because we are too focused on self and not on others? When we pray for others, we will become like our master. And so, as we become more like Jesus, God will allow us to grow more and more each day. Application, beloved. Prayer will draw us near to God. Prayer teaches us the way. Prayer opens our spiritual eyes. Prayer aligns our heart with God's heart. Prayer enables us to move forward. Wow. Beloved, let us be a praying people. May God help us that we will become the praying church that He wants us to be. God bless you. Until next time, God be with you.
Everything in your life, someone who can take all your wrongs and make them right. He can ease all your pain and strife if you just dedicate your life to Christ. Someone who will always be there for you when you're down, right there. Beside you, Jesus will always be around. He can be all these things for you. You must believe in Christ and see what He'll do. 'Cause God is so amazing. He is so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him and show what God has done. He is so amazing. God is so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him. Show that God is love. Someone who will comfort your heart and ease all your doubts. Somehow you know Jesus will always work it out. He can do all these things for you. If you believe in Him, He'll always see you through. 'Cause God is so amazing. He is so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him to show God is so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him. Show that God is love. Someone's there for you, no matter where you are. A friend when you're in need, you are a shining star. A guiding light to help you make it through your day. You must believe in Him, He'll always lead the way. Cause God is so amazing, He is so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him and show what God has done. He is so amazing. God is so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him and show that God is love. He is so amazing. God is so blessing and praising. Show what God has done. He's so amazing.
God is so amazing.
Yeah, let's bless Him and praise Him to show that God is love. He is oh. He is so God is
amazing.
He's
so amazing.
imagine
someone
who can change everything in your life.
Someone
who can take all your wrongs and make them right. He can ease all your pain and strife if you just dedicate your life to Christ.
Someone
who will always be there for you when you're down, right there.
Beside you,
Jesus will always be around. He can be all these things for you. You must believe in Christ and see what He'll do. 'Cause God is
so
amazing. He is
so
amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him and show what God has done. He is
so
amazing.
God is so
amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him. Show that God is love.
Someone
who will comfort your heart and ease all your doubts.
Somehow
you know Jesus will always work it out.
He can do all these things for you.
If you believe in Him, He'll always see you through. 'Cause God is
so
amazing. He is
so
amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him to show what God has done. He is
so
amazing.
God is so
amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him. Show that God is love. Someone's there for you no matter where you are. A friend when you're in need. You are His
shining star.
A guiding light to help you make it through your day. You must believe in Him. He'll always lead the way. 'Cause God is
so
amazing. He is
so
amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him and show what God has done. He is
so
amazing.
God is
so amazing. Let's bless Him and praise Him. Show that God is love. He is
so
amazing. God is
so
sound. Bless Him and praise Him. Show what God has done. He's
so
amazing.
God is so amazing.
Yeah, let's bless Him and praise Him to show that God is love. He is so. He is so. God is
amazing.
He's
so amazing.
God is
so.
My God is
so
amazing.
My God is so amazing.
So amazing.